Okay, it's only missing. I need to get something to investigate this place.
What are the old box ones?
How much, man? I thought you was a Wendigo, man. Don't ever walk up on me like that again. Do you hear me, boy?
So, there's this little case that the Popo, the 12, have been looking into, you know? And it says here that there was two kids that went missing in the woods at a fallen timber camp.
Wait. That rings a bell. Is it the place with the holes in the
bottom? Yeah. There's two kids that are dead in a ditch in this camp.
You don't think it could actually be...
Yeah, very well it could be. Yeah. I'm gonna need you and your little friend Jerry to go down there and investigate, and you need to record everything. We need to know everything that's happening down there and what it could be.
Can you see my head?
Alright. We're not talking yet, Jerry.
Alright.
It's case number 7, log number 1. We are at Fallen Timbers campground.
Carry on.
We're in Fallen Timbers campground here in the southeast part of Ohio.
Yeah. I'm actually from around here, and I heard about the killings that were going to be long about the back when I was younger. I planned them whenever I was young, so we're just going to sort of look into the future.
So right now, we're going to kind of be investigating these woods and seeing what I can see here, scout out. Find out what's in
here. Yeah, basically, that's all we're going to do.
We're about 3/4 of a mile away from where this incident happened. Right now we're looking for firewood for the night. We do not have very many resources for this. So. Got it, Jerry! See the woods behind me. Something's out there.
If that was a Wendigo, he'd be dead.
I think you're right.
Fire, you might want to watch out.
Good thing I watched out. This should do for now. Jerry's got some up here. Me and Jerry did some off-camera mining. Got our sticks. The entire campsite is set up for the night. We're ready to go.
Hi.
You good, Jerry?
Good God.
All right. God. Some time has gone by, and now we're cooking up dinner. We invited this man over to our campsite. He said he's seen a Wendigo, but I don't quite know if I believe him. But I haven't heard a story yet, so we'll see.
Jim.
this here is my friend Oswald.
He's looking at him kind of funny, but I think that's how he looks to people.
Hello.
What's my questions again?
Just ask him about the Wendigo.
Oh yeah, well, so what do you know about the Wendigo? Like, what is it attracted to?
Well, as far as I know, it's a whistle sound. And blood. Only because when I was in the woods with my family, trying to find food for my family, I found deer carcass. Eaten up by what I can only assume is the Wendigo.
So, how would you think we would catch this?
There's only one way to catch a Wendigo. How to go out into the forest. Typically by yourself is the best way, because when you have a group of people, it gets freaked out because they don't want to come near you. One-on-one, imano-imano type of deal. But it lacks the whistle sound.
So I can draw it in.
And if you have some blood laying around, that'll help you.
That was hilarious, Oswald. That was really good. What's the last question?
There's one more question. If you could describe what it would look like.
Oh! Yeah.
So, have you ever seen a Wendigo? What does it look like?
Tall, bony, and thin. Kind of looks like a deer carcass. With a buck horns!
Dismantled.
Yes, and it's like it moves like this.
Yeah, that's weird. So do you think like you think I can imitate the movement?
Yeah,
so
let's do it.
Is it like this? Like,
yeah, a little less T-Rexy. Yeah, similar to that.
Good, valuable information, Oswald.
Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you so much, sir. We'll let you go on your way. So, as you heard, Oswald there, he described the Wendigo as a carcassy, deer-like creature.
What is that?
That's nothing. Never mind.
Okay. We're not currently in the spot where the incident happened this summer, last summer in the Fallen Timbers campground. A couple children went missing, as many may recognize. Okay, but a couple children went missing. There was reports saying it was a bear, that they just got lost in the woods.
Got mangled dead by gosh darn bear.
It could have been anything. It could have been a person in the woods, but there have been some reports. It could have been Gary. But there were some reports saying that it was something deep or something. Perhaps supernatural.
This is spooky.
It's getting really spooky. We believe that the answer is unknown, and we're here to find this creature today. So this is the Fallen Timbers woods.
Wow.
As you can see.
Something over there. Did you just hear that?
Yes. It's very dark, very mysterious out here, but me and Jay over here are going to, we have a plan. We're gonna go investigate. Okay, let's go. Alright. After about 30 minutes of hiking, we got to the area where the kids went missing. It's in the southeastern part of the Fallen Timbers Park.
This was from the UNDS.
We also have us with us is, our weapon of choice, we have obviously a knife and other things, but we have flint steel. Apparently Wendigos don't like fire, so worst comes to worst.
We burn the whole forest.
We burn the forest down. Okay. So apparently they say you have to whistle. We're on trail now, so. Jerry, you want to go ahead and give us a couple whistles?
I can't whistle.
Jerry, you can't. That was the one job requirement. You had to whistle.
Yeah, no, I can't. Was that good? Was that adequate?
Okay, I'll try. Let's keep walking.
one monotone whistle, not a beat or anything.
Just one single.
Okay, I'll try. Here you go. Hear a peep, Jerry.
Maybe it was just
me that made the kids go missing. That's
I'm
also
just
possible.
Kidding, I would never do.
Oh, okay, that's good. That's good. Okay. Well, we gotta keep going. Oh my gosh. We've been hiking for an hour on this trail. Jerry. Please, just be quiet. Okay, I've been hiking for like an hour down the trail. Alright, there's what the plan B.
What in the tarnation of plan B?
Wendigo's like blood.
I'll do it. I like blood.
I was gonna do it, but it's okay. I'll much rather you do it. Let me hand you my knife.
Oh yeah, look at that puppy. Python.
Here's the knife.
Into.
Okay, this is your discussion device for this. Okay, go ahead and draw.
You smell that? Yeah, I know you smell it, Wendigos.
Dude, what if we try to... Oh my...
Where'd that just come from?
You heard that? It was this way. It was right down there. Yeah. Alright, I know you guys, it's hard to see, but there's a valley down there. And...
Oh.
Okay, it was down this way. Get down! You heard that, Oh my goodness, it's out there somewhere, I just heard it. Jerry, go on that tree, boy. Get down. Hide, Jerry. Go there. Oh my goodness. Hey, stay quiet. Hey, you might turn your flashlight off. Just.
You get up there?
Yeah, it's getting hard to see. We just heard a terrible, terrible screech. I don't know what it was. Hey, Jerry. 5 o'clock.
Oh my God. Oswald was right. That thing is terrifying. So how are we gonna do this?
I'm gonna let this up. When? Oh, it's not working. It's not working.
That's not right. Hold on. It won't work. It's not working.
It's right there. Can you see it?
It won't work. It's not working. What do I do? What do I do?
Go, get out. Those flint seals aren't working. It's when it goes right.
I'll sacrifice myself.
No, like we can't. It's blocking. If we can get back to the campsite, if we can get back to the campsite, there's fire over there. There's fire. It's blocking your only entrance. Boss.
That's what I wish, man.
You found.
Found? Well, good job, fellas. Where's Jerry at?